Welcome to D.M. Therrell High School's virtual celebration.
Yellow buses to the schoolhouse, hitting four classes a day. Freshmen and juniors and sophomores, all in a hall and all in your way, yes, it's done. That cap on your head, that gown round your neck, and that counselor finally clearing you saying, check, it's done. That feeling right now where nothing compares, and knowing that now in the mirror you stare to look at yourself just as sure as the sun, having all of your credits and finally saying it's done. Congratulations, it's time to celebrate. I'm happy, we're happy, you're happy. And for all of the aunts and the uncles and the grandmothers and the grandfathers and the cousins and the mothers and the fathers and the friends and the neighbors and everybody who has joined us during this time, it is time for us to turn up the volume. It's time to put on your caps and put in your gowns, grab some good mood food, and let's sit back together as APS delivers these celebrations from our heart to your living rooms as an honor to the class of 2020.
It wasn't supposed to be like this. We were looking forward to the end of our senior year and graduation. Then this happened.
I think people should be concerned, and the one issue here is that we don't really know the extent of the outbreak.
Of all the things we could have dreamed of for this moment, this was not.
The Centers for Disease Control says the coronavirus.
26 people have died.
The Metro, most school districts are planning to close.
We have all been impacted by this. One moment, we were all together, and in the next, we were at home with family and loved ones, adjusting and adapting to change and uncertainty.
Temporarily closing schools, so that means districts have to plan for that right now.
We never thought that would be the last time we would see each other. That we would miss walking across the stage together and celebrating the fact that we made it. Yet through it all, we are here. We battle through the tough times together. Though distant, we remain connected. We learn together, and we will finish this journey together. We are unstoppable. We have a legacy to keep, dreams to fulfill, and this won't keep us from our commencement. Though this is not how we saw it in the beginning, we embrace this moment. We celebrate that we made it here, and all of those who helped us and taught us along the way. One day, we will tell the story of the class of 2020 and how, through it all, we are here.
Can you see by the dawn? I pledge to do my best for Therrell and work to achieve the school goals. I am committed to striving to do better. I am continuously improving. I will look up, not down, look forward, not back. I will uphold the standards of excellence and become the finest individual I could possibly be. I am a global citizen, positively impacting every life that I reach. I am college bound, college ready, and committed to succeed in life. I am a Therrell Panther.
To lose all the meaning of who you are. What is your definition of a true superstar? Is it beauty? Is it money? Is it power? Is it fame? Are you in it for the glory? What's the purpose? What's the gain? Everything you ever wanted got you tied up in chains. Be careful how you play the game, 'cause the same things that chose you are the same things that own you. The same thing that built you is the same thing that kills you. The same ones that praise you are the same ones that hate you. Funny how it all goes around. If you lose your soul, you lose it all. If you're at the top, then brace for the fall. Surrounded by faces, but no one to call. Funny how it all goes around. If you lose your soul, you lose it all. If you're at the top, then brace for the fall. Surrounded by faces, but no one to call. Funny how it all goes around. If you look through a microscope at this messed up world, you would see every scratch, every flaw, every ounce of dirt. Your so-called friends you're leaning on, but all they do is take. You say it's fine, but deep inside you wish you could escape. Everything you ever wanted got you tied up in chains. Be careful how you play the game, 'cause the same ones that shun you are the same ones that love you. The same words that break you are the same words that shape you. The same rules that blind you are the same rules that guide you. Funny how it all goes around. If you lose your soul, you lose it all. If you're at the top, then brace for the fall. Surrounded by faces, but no one to call. Funny how it all goes around. If you lose your soul, you lose it all. If you're at the top, then brace for the fall. Surrounded by faces, but no one to call. Funny how it all.
Please welcome our Superintendent of Atlanta Public Schools, Dr. Maria Karstarfin. She brings an impressive record in the transformational educational leadership with nearly 25 years of experience in diverse major metropolitan school districts. She is a passionate advocate for children and their families, APS, and its transformation. As a student, I know she has loved and supported all of us, my classmates, and the district staff who have inspired her every day for the last 6 years. We are honored to have her lead us, and we will miss her, and she will miss us. Reading her letter to the class of 2020 and saying her final farewell, our superintendent, Dr. Maria Karstarfin.
An open letter to the seniors of the class of 2020. To my beloved class of 2020, amid all the chaos and crazy surrounding what has become a global pandemic, I've been thinking about you, every single one of you, as our district works to maintain teaching and learning and some semblance of a normal school year, even as our school buildings remain closed. With you prematurely heading your separate ways, I've been reflecting on the power of the students of the class of 2020. You were starting seventh grade when I first met you, little middle schoolers that have now grown up into beautiful and compelling young men and women. It is you who give me the heart and passion to do this work. You are indeed hashtag worth the wait. And just as you have worked together to emerge from numerous struggles over your 13 years of schooling, you will emerge from this pandemic. Given how much you've achieved together, I know it may feel stressful and disorienting to have to face this latest challenge apart from each other. Even as you recognize the power of facing challenges together, you're told to face this particular one in isolation and at a distance. So it's lonely, it's scary, but it's not insurmountable. I've come to realize in my role as superintendent that while the immediate challenge of this virus does require us to be apart for a time, that's not the only challenge we're facing. The challenge before us is not just to make it through these next few weeks and months, because we will. What I see as the greatest challenge and opportunity for us is rebuilding the world on the other side of this, making it kinder, fairer, more just, and just much better than it was before. The disparities and inequities in our communities have always existed. However, they are exacerbated by the virus, and that is the world you will lead us through. You need to remember that, and I believe you are strong enough to persevere and rebuild our communities for the better. What gives me hope during these challenging times is that you, the leaders, the learners, the strivers that I've had the pleasure to watch grow over the last 6 years will be responsible for the building and shaping of that world, and you will do it together. As you move through the rest of your life, every job you take, every decision you make, every interaction you have will play a part in shaping that world. So these next few weeks provide opportune moments for you to think, uninterrupted by the usual school day-to-day routines, about who you are, what you want to be, and what you're going to do to rebuild that world. Take that time and do something great with it.
Therrell class of 2020, you've excelled in academics and scholarship with valedictorian to Destiny Geiger and salutatorian and star student F.A. Ajiwitsi. And you've made strides in the arts with Joshua Allen having his featured work at the High Museum and earning first for audio production at the APS Technology and Innovation Competition. Kanaya Mitchell took second place with her submission in the annual Black History Film Festival sponsored by the Marvin Arrington Foundation. You've also achieved in athletics as your softball team advanced to state and the boys basketball team won regions. These seniors are core members of the team that won state last year and was state runner-up this year. And your own Roman Sun was named as the region's basketball player of the year and named to the all-state team along with Rashawn Frederick by the AJC. I'd also like to thank the senior football players who over the years allowed me to practice with them every summer. Number 4, Patrick Britton. Number 58, Jonah Cotton. Number 9, Cameron Fortson. Number 13, Caleb Grimes. Number 55, Keith Jackson. Number 1, Jamonte Jean. Number 60, Cedric Kurtzy. Number 7, Rashad Pruitt. Number 25, Marquavius McClendon. Number 66, Jacobia Sims. Number 14, Bryant Sofer. Number 11, Kevin Williams. And number 6, Thomas Wright. Remember, Therrell, that you will always be Panthers. You're among the fiercest, smartest, most adaptable cats in the world. So take that strength forward, persevere, and continue making us proud.
I want to leave you with one final thought. Strength comes from struggle, and the strongest are those forged in the fight. You have already developed and demonstrated so much strength. I've witnessed in our conversations, projects, football practices, water polo games, and everything else we've done together. You are already strong, and by the virtue of being the class forced to brave this pandemic through to graduation, you will be the strongest, most resilient, most prepared students of your generation. Take that strength forward. Persevere and continue making us proud. Much love and air hugs, your Dr. C.
Good afternoon. My name is Miracle Smith. I am the 12th grade class president of Dame McLaughlin Therrell High School. While tomorrow brings a new journey, today marks the end of a chapter in our lives. No longer will we eat together in the cafeteria. No longer will we wear khakis, black slacks, and black or white button-downs. No longer will we sit together in advisory and listen to Ms. Powell and Mrs. Rogers motivate us scholars with their morning announcements. So, as we leave the hallowed halls of DM Therrell High School, we will become as small as our controlling desire, or as great as our dominant aspirations. All it takes is believing in oneself to make ourselves proud. The world is now our hallway. College campuses, office buildings, and military bases will now be our classrooms. With the assistance of our parents, extended family, administrators, teacher, and community, we have reached a milestone. We hope you all stay tuned for the next one, because we plan on making you proud of us all. Regardless of each and every one of our life circumstances, we stand here before you today as future leaders, your successors, the ones that will always make you proud, the Dame McLaughlin Therrell High School graduating class of 2020. Thank you.
We got so caught up. To the Daniel McLaughlin Therrell High School class of 2020. This moment right here signifies the next step in the rest of your life. In the words of Calvin Coolidge, nothing in the world can take the place of persistence. Talent will not. Nothing more common than unsuccessful men with talent. Genius will not. Unrewarded genius is almost a proverb. Education will not. The world is full of educated derelicts. Persistence and determination alone are omnipotent. The slogan, "Press On," has solved and will always solve the problems of the human race. Your perseverance and determination through the unexpected changes with the COVID-19 pandemic has been nothing short of remarkable. Scholars, you have shown an unprecedented amount of strength and persistence. Over the years, I have watched your joys and your pains, talked you through some of your negotiations with your teachers, mediated your disagreements, encouraged you through rough times to witness the beautiful transformation of boys and girls growing into powerful young men and women. I watched you endure through some of the most challenging situations that when others said you couldn't do it, you knocked down that barrier. When you doubted yourself, you found the perseverance and you challenged your deepest fears and you conquered it. And yes, we were hard at times, but even diamonds, as beautiful as they are, require immense pressure and intense temperatures to reach its highest potential. And without that adversity, and without that pressure, that diamond would never become the true treasure it was meant to be. So it is my prayer that for you, you will learn that this life owes you nothing, but you owe yourself everything. You have the right to be smart. You have the right to be brilliant. You have the right to the desires of your heart. And you have the right to make your own mistakes because that's how you learn. But just don't let those mistakes make you. You have the right to the very best life ahead of you, and don't you ever let anyone take that from you. I challenge you to never settle. I challenge you to demand the best in every aspect of your life. I challenge you to be your beautiful and powerful selves. Beyond measure. You are brilliant, you are gorgeous, and you are talented, and you are the 2020 class of Daniel McLaughlin Therrell High School. Go forward and be great.
The Principal's Leadership Award is given to a deserving senior who displays strong leadership qualities to his or her peers, in the community, and in the classroom. The Principal's Leadership Award recipients for the class of 2020 are Frederick Moore and Miracle Smith. The Superior Attendance Award is given to a student that has maintained outstanding attendance over 4 academic years. The Superior Attendance Award recipients for the class of 2020 are Bryce Richards and Jamaris McElhaney. The Atlanta Journal Cup is an award given by the Atlanta Journal-Constitution to the best all-around scholar and is voted on by the faculty and staff. The Atlanta Journal Cup recipient is to Destiny Geiger. The Faculty Cup represents a senior voted on by the faculty and is the runner-up to the Atlanta Journal Cup. The Faculty Cup recipient for the class of 2020 is Abubakar Berry. Each year, the Atlanta Board of Education permits each traditional high school to designate a valedictorian and salutatorian for each graduating class. They are chosen at the end of the first semester of the senior year based on the numerical grading system used by Atlanta Public Schools as required by the State Board of Education. The STAR program is designed to recognize high school seniors who have the highest SAT score in their graduating class and meet all other program requirements. Our STAR student is Efe Ajuwitsi. Our salutatorian is Efe Ajuwitsi. Our valedictorian is to Destiny Geiger. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Efe Ajuwitsi, and I'm the salutatorian and STAR student of DM Therrell High School. Can't believe the moment has finally arrived, and we are ready to graduate? This wasn't the graduation that I was expecting, but I guess it will do. It's an honor to be in front of your screens today as we celebrate the day that we get awarded for our hard work. If I'm going to be honest, I never understood people who say that high school flies by, because these had to be the longest 4 years of my life. Doing work for free for 4 years is no joke. When I was told that I had to write a speech, I was like, man. But after a while, I wondered, what should I write about? What should I write about? I wasn't going to stand here and try to be a motivational speaker by telling you guys to reach for the stars or not quit when things get hard, because I don't even do that. So today, I want to take time to reminisce about our high school experience. Now that I look back on it, as a class, we overcame a lot. Everything started in ninth grade, looking for our classes on that confusing sheet of paper, hoping that we had the same classes as our friends. Who could forget walking through the halls with our wrinkled white polo shirts, hearing Coach Crane blow his whistle in everyone's ears? Then getting to class late, just to hear that we needed a pass, which only met us later. As a class, we survived 4 years with slow internet connection because barely anyone knew the Wi-Fi password to the good network. And for some reason, I think that they did this on purpose. And even this did not stop us from getting on our phones in class. As a class, we were forced to wear uniform every day, but decided to wear it every other day. And we all know those few people who never wore uniform and never got caught. Together, we got our exercise in by running to catch the bus just for the bus to drive off without us on it. We overslept and missed the bus, or we did both of these things and got lectured for missing the bus. As a class, we survived the hundreds of assignments on Google Classroom and articles that we had to read in Mr. DeGar's Human Geography class, the tons of essays that we had to write and books that we had to read in Ms. Stark's English class, and the extremely hard quizzes that we had to take in Ms. Gordon's math class. These are nearly all the teachers that caused the stress, with these other honorable mentions. Now that we are in 12th grade, graduating, I can say we do the exact same things that we did in ninth grade. We still try not to wear uniform, still miss the bus, and still play on our phones in class. However, through all of this, we stuck together as a class. We helped each other when we were sad, celebrated together when we were happy, and supported each other through hardships. In the words of Cesare Previsi, we do not remember days, we remember moments. These 4 years were full of moments that we will remember forever. Congratulations, class of 2020, and I hope to see all of you in the future.
Hello, my name is Tedesney Geiger, and I am the valedictorian of Dame McLaughlin Therrell High School, class of 2020. Before I begin, I would first like to thank faculty, staff, family, and friends for coming today to celebrate the class of 2020. I would also like to thank the class of 2020 for staying strong and making it to the finish line. I commend all of my peers here today for doing what many thought we would not be able to do, graduate. We have so much to be proud of. The class of 2020 has had numerous trials and tribulations that have shaped us into the scholars you all see before you today. In all honesty, the journey to this point has not been easy, but along the way, we slowly began to discover ourselves and the impact we want to have on the world. All of our hard work and dedication has led us up to this point, and today we are here to celebrate. Mark Twain once said, "There are only two types of speakers in the world, nervous and liars." By the end of this speech, it will be clear that I'm definitely not a liar, but I am nervous. When it was announced that I was valedictorian of class of 2020, the first thought that came to my mind was, I really do not want to give this speech. It was because I could not do it or I did not want to do it, but the simple fact that I had fear and anxiety. I felt an immense amount of pressure to stand in front of a large audience and not only speak my truth, but also the truth of the class of 2020 as well. Although I have butterflies in my stomach, the fact I can stand here at all is an indication of my growth. As I think back to our first day of high school, I remember all of our eagerness to get to the top floor and start our journey as freshmen. The race to the top started off pretty even. We all went full speed ahead with our heads in the clouds and no knowledge of what was to come. We were not prepared for the stairs. As I'm sure many of you will agree with, those stairs were an uphill battle that took a lot of getting used to. The path to the top was a struggle, and little did we know it would soon become a metaphor for our entire high school career. As freshmen, we were bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, ready to take on whatever challenges were thrown our way. Thankfully, we kept the same tenacity throughout our high school career. Although we are not as bright-eyed and bushy-tailed as we were then, we still possess the same willingness to conquer any obstacle. As sophomores, we struggled to find our place at D.M. Therrell High School. It was a very awkward stage for many of us. We were given our wings, but many of us did not know how to fly. Then there was junior year. We finally had a grasp of what it took to navigate a high school. But with the knowledge came a lot of responsibility. As juniors, we were not able to fly, but many of us had no direction. Last but not least, I reflect on our senior year, the year where our mental state was challenged the most. I'm sure that most of us had an idea how our senior year would progress, participate in senior activities, go to prom, and have an amazing graduation to celebrate all of our accomplishments. Unfortunately, that was not how our senior year planned out. But adversity is not an unfamiliar territory for the class of 2020. Although we were disheartened about not being able to spend our last months as seniors with the classmates we have grown with over the last 4 years, we have proved to ourselves that we have the inner strength to overcome adversity. We picked each other up and pushed ourselves to the finish line. In the words of Michelle Obama, there's no better than adversity. Every defeat, every heartbreak, every loss contains its own seed, its own lesson on how to improve your performance the next time. As I give this speech, we are in unprecedented times. I have learned tomorrow belongs to the people who prepare for today. Class of 2020 has always been the class to not only navigate unfamiliar waters, but also find ways to come out of the storm better than before. If you all remember nothing else from my speech, I hope you remember this. You are stronger than you know, and you possess all the qualities you need to be successful. To those of you entering college in the fall semester, work hard, make meaningful connections, and remember to have fun. To those of you who are entering the workforce or those taking off from school, please remember this. Your path to success is just that, yours. Do not allow others to dictate how you achieve your goals. To those of you who are not able to participate in this ceremony today, do not give up. We still have faith in you. Class of 2020, please remember that sometimes good things fall apart so better things can fall together. Congratulations on making it this far, but I know this is only the beginning. I cannot wait to see what the future holds for us. Again, congratulations, class of 2020, and continue to make history.
Thank you. Congratulations, Therrell High School Class of 2020. All of us on the Atlanta Board of Education are pleased that we are able to take a few moments to celebrate you, all of your classmates, some of your memories, and all of your accomplishments. Thank you for sharing with us. We pledge that there will be more and that someday, when circumstances are right and safe, we will celebrate live and in person with a full traditional ceremony. But for now, know that you are official graduates of Atlanta Public Schools. We, your parents, your teachers, your principal, your superintendent, your community, and your board members are certainly proud of you for graduating from high school. As you continue on your path through college, career, and life, know that you are not alone, even when we are apart. You always have the support of all the people who have been a part of your journey. Once again, on behalf of Atlanta Public Schools, congratulations and good luck. We love you and we will miss you. Go Panthers!
Congratulations to the class of 2020. We love you. We're going to miss you. Do well and conquer the world.
Class of 2020, I love y'all.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2020.
Hey, big shout out to all of our seniors, man. It's a great day, a beautiful day today. We out here to celebrate you. Big ups to Therrell High School, class of 2020. Hey, guys, congratulations for all the hard work. Thank you. Big ups.
I'm proud of all my seniors. Y'all did it. We did it. We're here. We're out celebrating for you all today. We're going to drive out. I'm really just really appreciative of this year being with you all. So really, thank you so much. Congratulations. Hey, best class, Therrell Panthers.
Hail to thee, dear Therrell High, black and red we wear with pride. Hail to thee, dear Therrell crew, honor and respect to you. We're believing and achieving, striving hard to reach the top. We will praise thee forevermore, Therrell High, we do love you so.
We thoroughly hope that you enjoyed this celebration of the class of 2020, and we look forward to seeing you face to face when conditions allow as we continue to celebrate and honor you as graduates, because you are hashtag worth the wait.